Hey everybody, Max coming here. It's a little cute podcast. It's not too long. Oh man, I've just been kind of in a shit mood today. I don't know about you guys, and I've just been kind of. I just woke up on the wrong side of the bed. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's because I was worked a lot, didn't sleep enough, or I don't know. I slept like 12 hours, you know. But I don't know. I've just been fucking. I've just been in a bad mood all day, you know, because my friend Jennifer made fun of my hair, and I was like, what are you, Jennifer, quit being a bitch, you're not even my friend, I don't know, why are you even here, who invited you, I'm deleting you on Facebook, you know. Anyway, I just didn't feel like doing anything today, you know, just kind of in one of those moods. I'm a moody mulligan. Mike. What name rhymes with Moody? I don't know. Moody Tootie. I don't know, man. I don't know what's going on. I just feel like, you know, I don't have anything to look forward to, really, you know? In my life right now. It's kind of... I think life's boring. No one has anything to look forward to, you know? A lot of my friends say the same thing, you know, they just like go to work and just come home, go to work, get drunk on the weekends, beat off, go home, you know, that's their life and just nothing really to look forward to. So it's like, what's the point of living, man? What are we even on the planet for, dude? Nothing means anything anymore, you know? Anyway. Got the fights tonight. I don't know if you guys watch the fights. TJ Dillashaw. He's fighting Henry Henry. He's fighting this guy Henry. You know, this is a very anticipated fight. Everyone's been looking forward to it. Everyone, this is the fight of the century, actually. But it was when it was with TJ Dillashaw and Demetrius Mighty Mouse Johnson. But then the UFC released Mighty Mouse, so now Mighty Mouse went to Japan to fight, and that was going to be the super fight, you know, Mighty Mouse versus TJ Dillashaw at 125, but no more Mighty Mouse, later Mighty Mouse, you know, and then he lost his last fight to Henry Cejudo, which was kind of a controversial decision, you know, they gave it to Cejudo, but it could have gone either way, in my opinion, you know. I think DJ did enough to maintain the belt, but yeah, that fight was kind of, it was a pretty even fight. Could have gone either way. Anyway, pretty much everyone thinks TJ Dillashaw is going to win this one, you know, because he's the superior fighter, pretty much. He's more creative, you know, TJ Dillashaw. I like watching him fight, you know, every time he fights, he always puts his hand over his head, like, you know, those 50 greaser guys, like, combing back their hair. TJ Dillashaw is always doing that in the ring, you know? He's always combing back his hair, you know? Like he's one of those 50 greaser guys. So he's putting his hand over his head, you know? Like he's combing back his hair. And then he just goes, well, bam! And punches you, you know? He's like, oh, don't mind me. I'm just combing my hair in this UFC ring. Well, bam! You know? You guys can't see right now, but I'm punching the air, you know? Maybe I need to get a video. Get the video podcast. You guys can see inside my bedroom, you know? Wait, hold on, let me think about if I'll do a video podcast. Nope. Man, that didn't come out right at all. I didn't pronounce any of those words correctly. Let me try one more time. Wait, hold on, let me see if I want to do a video podcast. Nope. There we go. Something's wrong with my mouth sometimes, you know? The words just don't come out, you know, I guess. I don't know. I've been studying Spanish too, you know, so like my accent, my vowel pronunciation, my diphthongs, and what's the other one? Yeah, well, I don't know if you guys are linguists or whatever, but, you know. They got these things called diphthongs. And, I don't even know what that means. I think it's when two vowels combine to form a new vowel sound. I think that's called a diphthong. I don't know. I need to study more, man. But, you know, to those of you in the stripper industry, a diphthong, that's when you put on your thong and you dip it in chocolate so the patrons can eat it off your vagina for $10 for 3 songs, you know. The songs are only a minute and a half, though, you know? Those aren't real songs. The strip club songs are just like one real song. 3 strip club songs, you know, there's a conversion right there, you know? It's like the dollars, like €1.30. And, you know, a pound is like, or an ounce is like 28 grams. And, you know, three stripper songs is like one normal song, you know? I mean, I don't know. I haven't been to a strip club since I was like 18. I remember I went there when I was 18. I was like, oh yeah, finally I can get some. I hadn't seen any tits in real life, really. You know, only on the internet, you know? Because I was a fat loser. So I was like, oh yeah, I finally got some tits in my face. And also I spent $50. Just for like a boner. I don't really understand the strip. You know, like in Japan, they got the thing. It doesn't really make any sense either there. You know, you pay money just to talk to girls. But I guess it doesn't really make any sense either in America. I mean, yeah, you get to see the girls, but you can't beat off on them or anything, you know? Well, you pay $50 just to get a boner? What's the point of that? That's just frustrating, you know? Pay $50 to get frustrated? That sounds fucking terrible. I need to invent some new type of prostitution. Yeah, I guess prostitution is where it's at, you know? You pay money. Pay money, you get your rocks off. That's the, you know. Does anybody say that anymore? Get your rocks off. I don't even. I think maybe that's an old term that my grandpa would use or something. You know. Dude, I got my rocks off. I guess as a metaphor, it makes sense. You know, it's like you got these rocks on you, and then after you have sex, you throw rocks on someone's face or something. I don't really know. I don't really understand how that phrase came about, you know. Anyway, I'm about to go over to my buddy's house, watch the fights, you know. I bought him some beers. I'm not going to drink them because I'm still doing the carnivore thing, you know. No carbohydrates, no alcohol. It's bad for you. It's poison. But I bought some beers just for him to enjoy, you know. Haven't seen him in like 9 years, you know, because I've been in Japan, so. You know, he's all grown up now. He's got a family. That's what happens when you leave for almost 10 years. You come back. Everybody's got kids. Not me, though. Still no kids. Woo! You know, anyway, that was a few minutes. Thanks for listening, man. We'll see you tomorrow.